couple days ago, I started to make a crappier version of the video you're about to make now. When I saw Chris Titus Tech come out with a video along the same lines, I was like, oh, it's time to give up as a YouTuber. He beat me to it. But fortunately for me, I've never been so happy to have been wrong. While I like Chris, he managed to complicate something a little bit more than it needed to be. By a lot. Like, a lot.
Right, see where that actual disc is, and I don't see it actually in here.
Why are we using the command line for this?
Fortunately, in this video, we're going to quickly show you how to accomplish the same thing, like, a lot faster. So here's how it went. A couple days ago, I fired up my PopOS install, ran updates, it's been super, super stable. And then I got this Grub-PC update that came through that asked me to install Grub manually again, using their tool, more or less manually. And yeah, it should have booted. One of my computers it did, the other one it didn't. Okay, well, that was irritating. And while I was tempted to distro-hop once again, which I haven't done in about 10 months, I decided against it and downloaded the Super Boot Disk. Now, the Super Boot Disk is a tool I've been using for a very long time to repair broken computers that won't boot, whether it's Windows or Linux, or Windows and Linux. It does the trick really easy. And within a minute or two of using my functional computer to make one of these bootable USB drives, and you can learn how to make bootable USB drives in one of my other videos, I was up and running. It was really, really easy. It was, besides making the actual bootable USB disk, I think there was a mouse click and one keystroke or two keystrokes, and that was it. Here is a screenshot of what it looks like when it boots up. And literally all you do is click that recommended or automatic repair button there, and when it says it's done, you reboot, take the new bootable USB drive out that you made, and you're booting again. Now, a word about dual booting. I do not recommend dual booting under any circumstances unless you have two separate drives, one for Windows, one for Linux, or whatever operating systems you're using, because using the select temporary boot device built into your computer's motherboard, it is way less likely to have any issues than Grub. And in this case, I actually wasn't even dual booting at all when my computer stopped booting. So, yeah. Right now I am dual booting, actually, for a few games on Windows. And it's fine. I just choose temporary boot device on startup, otherwise it goes straight to my main SSD, which is PopOS. So I hope this video was informational for you, and see you next time.